Lucha Libre and the Mexican Luchadores. Lucha Libre, which literally translates to free fight, is actually the Spanish term for wrestling. The Luchadores are the wrestlers. If these walls and these 18,000 seats could talk, they would tell the story of the most famous wrestling building in all of Mexico, Arena Mexico in Mexico City. In 1932, the boxing promoter Salvador Luderoth saw American pro wrestling for the first time while visiting Texas. Just 1 year later, he promoted the first ever wrestling card in Mexico, beginning a streak of 64 consecutive years of Lucha Libre at this site. In 1934, Luderoth added masked wrestlers. The mystery proved to be a huge drawing card. Lucha first boomed in the 40s, with stars such as El Santo and Gory Guerrero debuting during this decade. The 1950s saw the advent of television and the cinema. Charismatic masked wrestlers like Santo were portrayed as superheroes in a series of entertaining B-movies. In many instances, the movie villains were portrayed by the rule breakers of the ring. Battle lines are drawn between Rudos and Tecnicos. A Rudo, meaning rough or rude, is not simply someone with a nasty disposition, but one who uses an unorthodox brand of wrestling. A Tecnico relies on technical mat skills and are often fan favorites. The 1980s was the era of the second generation wrestler. The sons of the pioneer wrestlers came into prominence, names like Hijo del Santo and Eddie Guerrero. In 1994, WCW co-promoted the first pay-per-view featuring the Luchadores when worlds collide. This was step one in forming an association with the various promotions from Mexico like EMLL, or the Mexican Wrestling Empire, the oldest and most established group whose home is the famous Arena Mexico, 64 years and going strong. Promo Azteca, a new promotion, the home of many WCW stars. AAA was the co-promoter of When Worlds Collide. UWA, popular in the mid-70s, now not considered among the national powers. World Championship Wrestling went back to the past to find the future of pro wrestling. Associations between U.S.-based promoters and Mexico date back over 50 years. Next time, we'll explore the mystery and the history of the mask and the role it plays in Lucha Libre.